Hi, I'm Jay Alexander, formerly of WPEG Power 98, Metro Networks, Magic 96.1, where I was blessed to work with the late Rockin' Ray Gooding and Harriet Coffey, Metro Networks, where I did traffic mornings and afternoons with my dear friend, the late Nate Quick. Currently, I'm the program and music director of WBTF 107.9 The Beat in Lexington, Kentucky. I'd like to thank my dear friend and former co-worker, Margaret Ingram Jones, of giving me the honor of introducing our guests. She's the first African-American DJ at WSOC, Charlotte's number one country station, number one midday host on WBAV 101.9 and 105.3 R&B, where she hosted and produced. She worked extensively with the fly jock Tom Joyner and my dear friend Steve Harvey. She's a proud alumnus of UNC Chapel Hill and proud to be Salisbury born and bred. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Cheryl Girl Patterson Coe.
Good evening, I'm Cheryl Girl, and I would like to say welcome to everyone to the Dunbar School Alumni Association First Sports Hall of Fame, July 10th, 2021. The purpose of the association is to unite former students, teachers, spouses, friends, and community in order to perpetuate the heritage of the former school and to provide scholarships to the descendants of former students, teachers, or administrators of the school. Starting in 2007, they started with 3 scholarships. To date, we have awarded as many as 70 scholarships. This induction ceremony is brought to you by many ad and patron sponsors. They're listed in the ad and patron program, and our association is grateful and appreciative. Thank you. This event is a virtual presentation via Facebook and YouTube, so call up your family and friends and tell them to connect with us. Tonight, we will induct all 17 of the Dunbar School 1959 State Basketball Champions into our first Sports Hall of Fame, including Coach Harry Koontz and the manager, Larry Sturdivant. The players were Joshua Drafton, Walter Garrison, Clarence McKee, Robert Wiley, Wallace Davis, and Rufus Scotton. These were the 6 players who played throughout the basketball game. The other valuable team players were Robert Henderson, Robert Cockrell Jr., Harold Goodlett, Charles Hoover, Hubert Corpning, Frank Davis, Olin Lee Blair, Nehemiah Hawkins, and Curtis Blair. Now it's time for some entertainment. Tonight we will have 4 presentations, including a comedian. And to kick it off, just right, ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you Triple Threat Dance and Charm, led by the instructor, Sari Crystal. This program helps to build self-esteem and confidence while instilling an appreciation for the art of dance, theater, etiquette, and pageant preparation. They've won several awards and competitions locally and nationally. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Triple Threat Dance and Charm.
When I think of home, I think of a place where there's love overflowing. I wish I was home, I wish I was back there with the things I've been knowing. When that makes the tall trees bend into leaning, suddenly the snowflakes that fall have a meaning, sprinkling the sea makes it all clean. Suddenly my world's gone and changed its face, but I still know where I'm going. I have had my mind spun around in space, and yet I've watched it growing. Oh, if you're listening, God, please don't make it hard to know if we should believe the things that we see. Tell us, should we run away? Should we try and stay, or would it be better just to let things be? Living here in this brand new world might be a fantasy, but it taught me to love, so it's real, real to me. And I believe that we must look inside our hearts to find a world full of love, like a night
Triple Threat Dance and Charm. Great job. And a special thank you to Ms. Sari Crystal and their artistic director and founder, Crystal Stooks. Next, we would like to welcome our next guest from the class of 1958 and currently serving as the Dunbar School Alumni Association Treasurer, Ms. Hazel Stout Kennedy.
Good evening. My name is Hazel Stout Kennedy. I'm the treasurer of the Dunbar School Alumni Association, Incorporated. We organized in 2004. Maya Angelou said, and I quote, "Life is not the measure by the number of your breath that you take, but by the moment that takes your breath." I'm excited and honored for this particular moment to present these five plaques to the inductees or their family members. We are honoring 17 inductees for winning the North Carolina State Basketball Championship in 1959. I'll read the plaque in its entirety, but only the names of the other inductees. The plaque reads, "Dunbar School Alumni Association, Inc. introduced Mr. Harry Kuntz, coach, into the Dunbar Sport Hall of Fame this 10th day of July, 2021. For his outstanding participation in the 1959 championship games. To God be the glory." The next plaque is presented to Larry Studevant. Joshua Drafton. Robert Bobby Wiley and Robert Cockrell Jr. Thank you.
I'm Joshua Drafton, a graduate of Dunbar High School class of 1959. I lived for 3 years as a member of the basketball team. My senior year, I led the team in scoring and rebounding for the 1959 state champions. I was selected as a member of the all-tournament and the all-state team. I was rewarded with a four-year scholarship to North Carolina Central. I enrolled, but for personal reasons, I decided not to stay. I am married to my wife for 55 years, Rachel Drafton. We have a daughter, Vanessa Ross, and a granddaughter, Domika Buford. I enlisted in the United States Army in 1961 and retired in 1981. During my military career, I played basketball in Korea, Maryland, and Turkey. In Turkey, I was offered a contract to play for the Turkish national team, but because of my military obligations, was unable to accept. When I retired from the Army, I continued my education and earned an associate degree in computer programming from Georgia Military College and a bachelor's degree in public administration with a minor in criminal justice from renowned University in Gainesville, Georgia. I graduated from the Police Academy and was hired as a youth development center in Augusta, Georgia. Within a six-year period, I was promoted to sergeant, lieutenant, and captain. 3 years later, I was elevated to a regional training coordinator for the Department of Juvenile Justice. My job was to train all state employees in pre-service and in-service training. I have resided in Augusta, Georgia for 46 years. I'm a member of the Luzerne Hill Missionary Baptist Church and have served as an ordained deacon for 21 years. I'm also a member of the Pastor Support and Mail Corps. I have, with approval of my pastor, Reverend Dr. James Arthur Hogan, established a Christian leadership school at Luzerne Hill. The school is sanctioned by the National Baptist Convention and with Sunday School Publishing Board, I met the qualification to be a dean by attending numerous workshops throughout the country, and alongside with my educational background, I was a certified dean and instructor for the National Baptist. It is an honor to be selected as a member of the Dunbar Basketball Hall of Fame.
Good evening.
I am Dr. Jerry Wiley, Dunbar High School class of 1966. It gives me great pleasure and an honor to present my older brother, Robert Norman Wiley, better known as Bobby, posthumously as a member of the undefeated 1959 Dunbar High School men's basketball team and as an inductee into the Dunbar Sports Hall of Fame. Bobby was one of the most competitive people you would ever want to meet. He wanted to win at every game we played as children, whether it be checkers, dominoes, cards, and yes, sports. He taught me all those games, but he would never let his younger brother win. In high school, Bobby would probably most want to be remembered as a student athlete. He graduated with honors, co-captained the 1959 state championship team, and was named an all-state player. He was known for playing both ends of the court, both offense and defense. He later went on to attend Livingstone College there in Salisbury. While attending Livingstone, Bobby was a member of the Dean's List all 4 years and a starter on the basketball team for 4 years. In addition, during this time, he was named to the All-Conference team. In 1963, Bobby earned a bachelor's degree of science with honors in biology from Livingstone College. After graduation, he worked in the Charlotte-Mecklenburg school system as an instructor of science and then as an assistant science director of the Museum of Science there in Charlotte. While working in Charlotte, he earned his master's degree in science from Antioch College in Yellow Springs, Ohio, in 1970, with a concentration in chemistry, biology, and geology. Other studies in geology and astronomy were done at North Carolina A&T State University and at Notre Dame University. After leaving the school system, Bobby worked for IBM for 30 years in sales and marketing until his retirement in 2002. While with IBM, he traveled the world in over 40 countries introducing marketing programs. Bobby would also like to be remembered as an outstanding and loving father, grandfather, son, and brother. He was truly the consummate all-around person who led by example. Congratulations, Bobby, on a well-deserved honor.
Hello, my name is Robert Cockrell Jr. My wife is Yvonne Correll Cockrell. We met at Dunbar High School in 1960. We've been married for nearly 55 years. We have three adult children, Jeff, Todd, and Tasha. I'd like to thank the Dunbar School Alumni Association for putting together its first ever Sports Hall of Fame 2021, and to recognize the 1959 Dunbar High School team and their state championship. I happened to be a part of that team. I was a freshman at that time, and it was a good time to be at Dunbar. We had just moved into a new building. We had a brand new gymnasium, and I happened to make the team. I remember all of the hard work that we put into that year. We used to run outside if the weather permitted, and we would run laps. There was a street next to the school. We would run laps until Coach Coots got tired, and then we would move into the gym and do what we call full court layups. And that we ran those until Coach got tired. So there was a lot of hard work, and after each practice, I remember having to walk home along with a teammate. He and I walked about 3 to 4 miles just to get home, but it was well worth it. It was a remarkable season. We went about 21-0 officially, but unofficially we had a practice game with the Rowan County Detention Centers. And we won that game. So we went 22-0 plus a state championship. We had some remarkable basketball players and a great coach. These guys knew how to play. They were very efficient, very talented, and they were masters on the basketball court. I happened to be a freshman. I was a part of the team. I didn't get to play, but I was there to support. I can remember that these guys were outstanding young men. They were role models to the rest of the students, and we had a wonderful year, 1959. Also, as Ben at Dunbar, I was also a member of the first football team coming back to the school. And as a result of that team, I was able to win an athletic grant to Livingstone College, and which led to an extension of my career at Livingstone College for the next 4 years on its football team. After college, I was able to teach a few years, about 8 years in high school. And after that, I started my own business, insurance business, which was very successful. But again, I like to thank the Dunbar School Alumni Association for putting this together, the first ever Sports Hall of Fame, and to be recognized as one of the participants of that 1959 State Basketball Association Championship.
Thank you, Mrs. Kennedy, and congratulations to our first set of inductees into the Dunbar School Sports Hall of Fame. Our next entertainment presentation comes from S2C Mime of Charlotte, North Carolina. They are professional dancers, including a Dunbarian's daughter, granddaughter, niece, and cousin, Miss Denisha Herndon of Charlotte. She is a girls' middle school basketball coach, and she is the first dancer in the video. Miss Herndon sends a message of congratulations, which reads as follows. My name is Denisha Herndon. It is my honor to congratulate the Dunbar School 1959 Sports Hall of Fame State Champion inductees. I would also like to pay tribute to my father, Dennis Herndon Sr., his siblings, my grandparents, and all of my relatives who attended Dunbar. May the Lord continue to bless you, keep you, and give you the strength to rise up above every obstacle that comes your way. With love, Denisha. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome S2C Mime.
You're broken down and tired of living life on the merry-go-round. And you can't find a fighter, but I see it in you, so we gon' walk it out. Move mountains. We gon' walk it out and move mountains. And I rise up, I rise like the day. I rise up, I rise unafraid. I rise up and I do it a thousand times again. And I rise up, I like the waves. I rise up, in spite of the ache. I rise up, and I do it a thousand times again. Be you, be you, be you, be you. The silence is a quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe. And I know you feel like dying, but I promise we'll take the world to its feet. Move mountains, bring it to its feet. Move mountains. And I'll rise up, I'll rise like the day. I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I do it a thousand times again. Be you, be you, be you, be you. And for that we have each other. I will rise a thousand times again, and we'll rise up. I like the waves. We'll rise up in spite of the ache. We'll rise up, and we'll do it a thousand times again. You. You.
great job, and we appreciate the fancy footwork. Thank you, STC. Next, we would like to welcome Essie Graham Ruffin from the class of 1967, who currently serves as the Dunbar School Alumni Association Financial and Correspondence Secretary. She will introduce the next inductees' plaques, followed by the inductees and their families.
Good evening. My name is Essie Graham Ruffin. I am a Dunbar High School graduate with the class of 1967. I will be presenting the awards today for the following inductees. I will read one of the plaques. Dunbar School Alumni Association, Inc. inducts Wallace Davis into the Dunbar School Sports Hall of Fame this 10th day of July, 2021, for his outstanding participation in the 1959 state championship game. The next plaque goes to Mr. Frank Davis. Mr. Robert Henderson. Mr. Clarence McKee. Mr. Walter Garrison. And Mr. Curtis Blair. Thank you, and my congratulations to all the inductees.
Hello, this is Patricia Davis Cross, and I am the sister of Frank Davis, who has been inducted in the Dunbar School Hall of Fame. And I just want to tell you a little about him. He was a very fun-loving guy. And the song you hear in the background was his favorite, and he loved to imitate James Brown. He also had 6 children and many great-grandchildren. And I also have another brother, Wallace Davis, who I'm proud to say was inducted also in the Dunbar School Hall of Fame. And I just want to thank you guys for the honor, and I accept this award on behalf of his family.
Hello everyone, my name is Valicia Davis Morgan. I am the daughter of John Wallace Davis. You all know him as Wallace Davis. It is a honor knowing that my father will be inducted into Dunbar Alumni Association. My dad has always had the love for sports. Of course, I was a little young, or I may not have been born at the time. However, I had heard many, many stories of my father in his younger days, and I heard nothing but great, phenomenal things about him. And this carried on until he got older, the love of sports, basketball, as well as football. My father was a love of the Philadelphia 76ers, and he also loved the Philadelphia Eagles. Two of his favorite teams. And that's what I always will remember about my dad. Just always being happy and loving. Anyone, not only to me, but to anyone in his presence. I just want to thank you all for acknowledging my dad. And we truly, truly appreciate this. Not only myself, but his family as well. His loving sisters who are still around. So that being said, thank you very much, and you all enjoy.
To the Dunbar School Alumni Association and to the first Dunbar School Sports Hall of Fame, my name is Clarence W. McKee, a member of the graduating class of 1959 and also a member of the undefeated state championship basketball team. Let me take you on a short journey as to what happened to me at Dunbar School. As a student at Dunbar School, third grade through the 11th grade, I was president of my classes. My senior year at Dunbar High School, I was the president of the student body. We played basketball under the illustrious Harry Koontz at Dunbar High School. We were state runner-ups in 1958 and state champions in 1959. We were a team composed of Joshua Drafton, Rob Wiley, Walt Garrison, Walt Davis, and myself. We had a team which was dedicated to sportsmanship, scholarship, and we believed in helping one another. We were not selfish. We believed in winning. That's why we were undefeated. No player had a 20-point average. All players averaged 10 to 17, 18 points a game. Therefore, we didn't lose any games because you couldn't stop five men. Whereby if you had an unselfish player playing for themselves, they could score 40 points and you still would lose. While at Dunbar, I had the honor of being on the honor roll. One thing my parents stressed, books first, sports next. So therefore, I was in my books. Upon graduation from Dunbar High School, I went to North Carolina A&T State University, where my freshman year, we started the sit-in demonstration at Woolworths. Can you imagine that? My mom and dad said, you cannot be out there in the forefront, but you can be supportive because we have our jobs at stake. So therefore, I was unable to be in the limelight. While at Dunbar High School, we had some of the best teachers that you could think of. We were all involved in academics, and therefore, nothing came up short in terms of the future. At graduation, Bob Wiley went to Livingstone College, Joshua Drafton went to North Carolina Central, and I went to North Carolina A&T State University. While at A&T State University, I was unable to play basketball for Cal Irvin because he had Al Atlas and Joe Howell, all Americans. And therefore, I went to work in the illustrious office of Ellis Corbett, who became the national president of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity. And I worked with Ellis Corbett for 4 years. While at A&T, I became editor in chief of the 1963 yearbook. I was the lone Omega to make Omega Psi Phi Fraternity in 1960, and I was the boss of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity. Without my upbringing and teachers and support staff at Dunbar High School, I would never have achieved what I have achieved today because I have been a guidance counselor, an assistant principal, director of special education for the school system, and at Winston-Salem State, I was director of the Upward Bound program and director of student support services at Winston-Salem State University. Therefore, what can I say? Dunbar, you have been a blessing in disguise for me because you prepared me for life. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Diane Garrison, the widow of Walter Garrison. This is our daughter, Amanda Garrison, our daughter, Cassandra, our son-in-law, Nick Bernardi, our grandchildren, Gianna and Gavin. My family and I would like to thank the Dunbar School Sports Hall of Fame for selecting Walter as one of the first inductees. This is such a great honor. We know
that he would be so proud. He was the 1960 MVP. During our 41 years of marriage, his love for basketball never diminished. After serving in the United States Navy, he worked for Maryland Naval Shipyard and retired from the Army Corps of Engineers. What I remember most about Walter was his ease at making new friends. He never met a stranger. He would want to be remembered as Annabelle and Willie's son, Diane's husband, Cassandra and Amanda's father, a man who was always there for his family.
The things I remember most about my father were his perseverance, his determination, and his integrity. These things made him an excellent athlete and a great father. These are the things that I am working hard to pass on to my family.
What I remember most about my father was his amazing smile and his ability to pull strangers and family together to celebrate good times as well as help people in their trials and tribulations. He was definitely a player in this game we call life, and he loved it as much as he did basketball.
We would like to congratulate all of the inductees into the Dunbar School Sports Hall of Fame. Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ms. Ruffin, and congratulations to our second set of inductees. Our next entertainment presentation is performed by a Dunbarian, Marion Parker. She's an apostle, she's a comedian, and she's an entrepreneur. Sit back, relax, and get ready to get your laugh on. Please welcome Miss Miriam Parker.
How y'all doing? This here Cindy May, coming to you live once again. I just stopped by long enough to congratulate the Dunbar School Alumni Association, and the first Sports of Hall induction ceremony. Listen, I got my blue and my white bling on tonight. Yes, sir, I come to say hello to all of you and come to spread some love to you. Celebration time, come on. Woo-hoo! Celebration time, come on. Woo! Hey, we gonna have a good time. Listen. I've been looking for them tigers they've been talking about, but then they came back and told me, no, ma'am, we ain't lost no tigers. We ain't looking for no tigers. We is the Dunbar Tiger. Yeah, I'm feeling real good tonight. Yeah, I'm feeling real good. Thought I'd put on my blue and my white bling. To let y'all know that Cindy May got your back. Yes, I do. And I'm happy for you. I'm so happy. I feel like singing some more. But listen. I was sitting here trying to try on my bracelets. Yeah, I guess that ain't none of your business. But thank y'all so much for stopping by and allowing Cindy May to be a part of your celebratory system tonight. And I just thank God for all of y'all. Let me tell you, love, peace, soul, and learn how to laugh. Because laugh do a good like medicine. And some of y'all constipated. Yeah, some of y'all need some little medicine, you know what I'm saying, to break up some of that constipation. Yeah, because they let me know, Miss Margaret let me know that there was a state championship in 1929. That's been a long time. So we need to go ahead and laugh some like a little bit tonight, at least just to get a little relief off of us. And laugh to do good. Like a medication. Yeah, you tell them Cindy May told you that one, okay? So listen, enjoy your celebration. And listen, when the COVID-19 is gone, then what we gonna do, us Dunbar people, the tiger men and the tiger women, Yeah, we're going to have to get together and celebrate. We're going to have to get together and have a good time. Soon as Covetta gone by her business. All right? Love your peace and show celebration time. Come on. We're going to have a good time. Celebration time. Come on. Hey, hey. Hey, celebration time. Come on. Peace out. God bless you, Dunbar people. Ah, and all your titles. Bye.
Thank you so much, Mrs. Parker. Next, we have Edward Lanier, a retired physician's assistant and a 1965 Dunbar graduate. He is a member of the Dunbar School Alumni Association, and he will present our final inductee awards.
Good evening. My name is Edward Lanier, class of 1965, and it's with my great privilege to induct the following Dunbar School 1959 state champions into the Dunbar School Sports Hall of Fame. And the inductees are Mr. Nehemiah Hawkins, Dunbar High School, Alumni Association Incorporated, inducts Nehemiah Hawkins into the Dunbar School Sports Hall of Fame this 10th day of July, 2020, for his outstanding participation in the 1959 state championship game. The next inductee is Mr. Olin Lee Blair. The next inductee is Mr. Hubert Copening. The next inductee is Mr. Rufus Bo Scotton. Next inductee is Mr. Harold Goodlett. And the next inductee is Mr. Charles Hoover. Thank you very much.
Good afternoon. I'd like to thank Dunbar Alumni Association. Thank you for nominating our father, Nehemiah Nesbitt Hawkins Jr., for Basketball Hall of Fame. We are the living descendant of our daddy, Nehemiah Hawkins. The things that we remember about our daddy, that he liked to cut up, he loved sweeps, he loved to dress, and he was one heck of a basketball player. His sons never did take the skills out there, but we still his sons. The things that I like for everyone to remember my daddy, Nehemiah Hawkins Jr., if you look at each of them has taken something away from what we like to cut up, what we like to dress, or what we like to, we love sweets. Once again, I thank Dunbar Alumni Association for nominating our father, Nehemiah Nesbitt Hawkins Jr. Thank you.
Hi, my name is LaWanda Blair Foster, and I'm the daughter of Olin Lee Blair, who was a proud member of the 1959 Dunbar State Championship team. First, I want to start off by thanking the Dunbar Alumni Association for asking me to take part in this induction in honor of my father's memory. My father was a proud graduate of Dunbar High School, and in growing up as a child, some of the fondest memories I have with him is going back to East Spencer and Salisbury from Philadelphia, where I was born and raised, to attend the Dunbar reunions every year. It was always a special time for me to go and meet and spend time with not only family and friends, but also classmates of my father, and to learn the proud heritage of Dunbar High School. My father graduated from Dunbar, went into the military, and then married my mother and moved to Philadelphia. He was there. He was a manager for the Philadelphia Sanitation Department. He also was involved in politics and always very active in the community, not just the community of Philadelphia, but he spent a lot of time in his adulthood going back to East Spencer and Salisbury to always remain a part of that community and to help those that that grew up in that area, family and friends and other people in the community that he was always felt a connection with. Again, I just want to thank you for allowing me to take part in this ceremony to honor my father, his memory, and the great memories that the 1959 state championship team brought to Dunbar High School. Congratulations to everyone on the team, and I wish you all the best. Thank you.
To Dunbar Alumni Association, on behalf of my late husband, Hubert Corpenning, thank you for this honor. Hubert was a member of the 1959 championship team. He was a 1960 graduate. We met in 1962 in New York, and we were married in 1964. And from this union, we had two daughters. Hubert worked for the Corps of Army Engineers in New York, and we later relocated to North Carolina, where he worked for Fiber Industries. He was a faithful member and a hard worker in his church, White Rock Amazon Church in Granite Quarry. He always remained connected to Dunbar through his lifelong friendship with his classmates. He would be extremely honored for this recognition. Thank you on behalf of our family. This will be an honor that we will always cherish.
Hello, I am Christy Corpenning Themster, the daughter of Hubert Corpenning. What I remember the most are the times that we spent with his brothers and sisters. He has 13 siblings, so there were many, many, many fun times. I will cherish the memories of our family vacations. I was always surrounded by family and love.
Hello, I'm Kimberly Corpenning McGee, and I am the daughter of Hubert Corpenning, your inductee. And it's so appropriate that he is being inducted into your Hall of Fame for a sporting event. My father was always very athletic. He taught us how to swim. He taught us how to play golf. And so it's very appropriate and ironic that he is being inducted for sports. He was an avid golfer in the community, and many people in the community became his friend because of golf and the connection of golf and his love of sports. My father was also such a friendly person. He never met a person that he didn't instantly become friends with his smile and his laugh. Everyone knows Hubert Corpenning with the gold tooth when he smiles and just chuckles. Those are the things that I will remember my father the most for. My father would want to be remembered as a Christian man who loved God and his family, especially his five grandchildren. They are truly his legacy. He had such a positive impact on the local golf community and the golf community within the AME Zion Church. He would definitely want to be remembered for having a positive impact there. He also want to be remembered for just being a loving, kind person and a true friend to those he loved and those who loved him. He would want them to have lasting, positive, funny, loving memories of him.
Again, thank you to the Dunbar School Alumni Association and those involved in organizing this program. This honor has given our family another opportunity to be proud of our father.
And my husband. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, my name is Rosalind Scotton. I am the niece of Amit Rufus Scotton, but we all called him Bo. I'm here to accept this award on behalf of my Uncle Bo. My Uncle Bo graduated from Dunbar High in 1960 and attended Livingstone College on a full basketball scholarship. Later, he was drafted in the Army and received an honorable discharge. He was awarded the National Defense Service Medal. After leaving the military, he became a plaster carpenter for 45 years in Rowan County. He retired from Bill Hefner Veteran Medical Center in Salisbury, North Carolina. After a brief period of illness, my uncle transitioned on August 7th, 2016. My Uncle Bo would have been honored to receive this award. Thank you, Dunbar School Alumni Association, for this award.
Our last entertainment performance is from Natalia House. She's dedicating I Look to You by Whitney Houston to the inductees and their families. Natalia is a West Rowan High School senior and a very popular dancer here in Rowan County and the surrounding areas. Natalia's grandfather, Maurice Dunlap Jr., is a Dunbarian who attended elementary school, and also several of his Miller family members are Dunbarians too. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Natalia House.
My name is Natalia House. It is my honor to congratulate the Dunbar School 1959 Sports Hall of Fame champion inductees.
As I lay me down, heaven hear me now. I'm lost without a home after giving. Storms have come and darkened my sun. After all that I've been through, who on earth can I turn to? I look to you, I look to you. You.
much, Natalia. Great job. And now as we wrap up the Dunbar School Alumni Association's first Sports Hall of Fame induction ceremony, I would just like to thank our talented performers for their time and their effort today. And I would also like to say thank you to the many people who've worked so hard to put together this amazing presentation. It is an honor and a privilege to be part of it. And as we conclude, I would like to introduce the Dunbar School Alumni Association as they present their recording secretary, Ms. Brenda Stout-Venning, to give the closing remarks. Thank you, everyone, and good night.
Good evening. On behalf of our President, Margaret Ingram Jones, our Vice President, William Kennedy, and our association members, thank you so very much for your participation in our first Dunbar Sports Hall of Fame. May God continue to bless you with good health and prosperity. Before I close, I would just like to thank God for the many blessings that He provided for us, because we could not have done it except through Him. Thank you, God, for all of our participants. Thank you, God, for all that you did for us. And we pray that until we meet again, that you all have a good night.